A word of comfort to one who is mourning. A word of hope whose spirits are crushed. And I think Cliff empathized and proved an example of that in his living. I did not know him personally very well, but listening to the stories, we give thanks to God's grace working. And sometimes probably in spite of Cliff, like all of us. And I want to close with these words from Scripture that will give us hope, courage, and comfort. Do not lose heart, for God has seen your tears and will deliver you out of all your troubling situations, and you will weep no more. That's what God promises. You will grieve, but one day your grief will turn to joy. And St. Paul writes in the first letter to the Thessalonians, the 4th chapter, but we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who are asleep, so that you will not grieve as the rest do who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus. That was the hope that sustained Cliff in his living, empowered him in his care and sacrifice for others, and will give you, grant you joy, peace, and joy each and every day. In Jesus' name. Amen. Trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give thanks to you because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us pray the prayer our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
God, the generations rise and pass before you. You are the strength of those who labor, and you are the rest of the blessed dead. We rejoice in the company of your saints. We remember all who lived in faith, all who have peacefully died, and especially those most dear to us who rest in you, especially our brother Clifford. Give us a time in our portion with those who have trusted in you and have striven to do your holy will. To your name with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we ascribe all honor and glory now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. We will sing our closing hymn, A Mighty Fortress Is Our God. And on the last stanza, we will begin processing out and gather on the front porch for the folding ceremony.
I'll give you a hug in a moment, buddy. I'm just feeling, getting this on film. This is going to work out really well. This will be a YouTube video in just as soon as I upload it. So it'll be able to have everybody. It's going to be a YouTube video that you'll be able to look at another time. Great seeing you.
Me too.
Vivian, I'd like you to meet dear old friend,
Willie.
I mean, no, this has been a mentor like Cliff was for me for years, so it's great having him here.
You didn't have to fly today.
I didn't have to fly today. I'm very lucky. I said to my boss how important this was. He says, I'm trying not to fly.
is our ceremony. You're all invited to join us at Letter Bowl.
Okay.